the sound that rocked the world. Hitsville became Motown, and Motown became a part of our lives. Tonight, we celebrate the Motown sound and the people who made it. Motown 25. Yesterday, today, forever. Richard Pryor, also starring Adam Ant, Cindy Birdsong, Dick Clark, The Commodores, DeBarge, The Four Tops, Marvin Gaye, Howard Hessman, High Energy, The Jacksons, Jermaine Jackson, Michael Jackson, Rick James, The Miracles, John Moshita Jr., Martha Reeves, Tim Reed, Lionel Richie, Smokey Robinson, Linda Ronstadt, Diana Ross, The Temptations, Junior Walker, Mary Wells, Billy D. Williams, The Lester Wilson Dancers, Mary Wilson, and Stevie Wonder.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Tonight, we're here to welcome all of you into our home and let you see us from the inside and to get to know us a little better. Our whole family is here to welcome you. And this next young man is a former Motowner, but once a Motowner, always a Motowner at heart, really. And we're absolutely thrilled to have him here, to welcome him home for tonight, if only for a couple of hours, to share this night with us and with all of you. This cat to me is one of the funniest and one of the world's most talented men. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Richard Pryor.
We'll be right back.
you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, and welcome to a most star-studded evening. And I mean star-studded. I've seen stars, and I've seen studs. And I want to tell you that this is star-studded. I mean, some of the things that you're going to see this evening are going to blow your mind. It's a charity, it's an anniversary, it's a reunion, a surprise party. It's a charity event and a salute to the music of Motown. We're going to look backwards and we're going to read. And we're going to look around the corner and under the rug. And there's going to be lots of things happening here tonight that you'll probably never see happen again. Like maybe me being serious. You just see what's going on backstage, like they're hugging and kissing, rubbing each other. I didn't want to leave and come out here. I'd like to show you something where our music started. This wonderful piece of machinery is a cutting machine. This is the machine that was in Hitsville that cut million seller records. And it's an old machine, as you can tell. But it's still turning. Not cutting anything right now, I don't think.
Are you cutting anything?
No. One of the superstars of Motown had this machine held up for a long, long time. He worked with the group in the early days and he married one of the members. No, it's not the Temptations. So see if you can guess which one.
When I became of age, my mother called me to her side. She said, son, you're growing up now. Pretty soon you'll take a bride. And then she said, just because you become a young man, there's still some things that you don't understand. Give you the wrong impression.
Ross and the Supremes now give the country a preview of this new hit record to be released tomorrow. They'll be singing the new record, Love Child, and here are Diana Ross and the Supremes. Diana Ross apparently is making a change. Diana Ross will be fired for this.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dick Clark.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you. You know, as much as any other force in this industry, Motown caused a revolution in music. It was a quiet revolution, but the ripple effect is still being felt all over the world. What Motown did was change our perceptions about black music and the people who made it. Now, until Motown came charging out of Detroit, about the only genuinely black thing about mainstream music was the vinyl from which the records were pressed. Watch this. Now, in the 50s and 60s, it was a common practice for white artists to take a song from a black performer, make their own version, and come out with a big hit. Now, those records were called cover records. Well, everybody from Elvis to an artist who later was to record for Motown, Pat Boone did it. Now, until Motown, most of America's record buyers didn't go looking for black records since they had hardly ever heard the real thing. But by the end of the summer of 1964, most of the teenagers were dancing in the street and they wanted Martha and the Vandellas singing it to them. At least that's the way it was on American Bandstand. Kids of all colors started hitting the record stores. From Motown acts alone, they had 42 hits from which to choose. And that also created a little confusion. There were certain areas that wouldn't stock an album with a black face on the cover. So Motown very often had pictures of other things on their albums. There was even an LP with two blonde lovers on the cover of an Isley Brothers album. But the kids persevered and they found Mary and Marvin and Stevie and Smokey and the Four Tops and the Temptations and a song from a trio of young girls that asked the musical question. The liberalism of the Kennedy years and the growing awareness of the civil rights movement helped set the tone for even wider acceptance. White radio, big time radio, began playing Motown hits. Not because of the color of the artist, but because the music was good.
You are the sunshine of my life.
Now suddenly there was a brand new batch of cover records, but with a twist this time. White artists were now singing acknowledged Motown hits.
But all is fair in love.
For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me. Not like it's hurt me before.
For once I have something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore.
Now that's progress. I was about to say, in the process of discovering and developing more superstar talent than any other company in the entertainment business, Motown changed the image of black performers. Also made great strides in improving the way blacks were presented in all ways of life. I'm very honored to be part of this celebration tonight and very equally pleased to have been at least in some small way a part of the Motown story as it unfolded. I really believe that Motown has built the potential for going on forever on a very solid foundation. And I wish them continued success and great happiness.
Oh, I thank you so very much, ladies and gentlemen. I thank all of you because all of you here have many different cultures and backgrounds have made it possible for a man with black culture to have a dream fulfilled. I thank you because in my lifetime, I never thought that I would experience magic. The moments of magic that I've experienced because of you, all of you, the members of Motown and the family, the different artists, management and staff, and friends. That magic of yesterday encouraged me to create music that I'm doing today and that I will do tomorrow. So therefore, there is magic that will last through yesterday, today, and forever. Stay in my heart.
The Motown sound was created by one of these three men. What is your name, please?
My name is Barry Gordy Jr.
My name is Barry Gordy Jr.
My name is Barry Gordy Jr.
Will the real Barry Gordy Jr. please stand up?
Although there were many outstanding solo performers signed to the label over the years, the groups were the one that gave Motown a special identity. Those wonderful groups with the optimistic names like Miracles, Supremes, Tops, Temptations, Pips. In the early days, Motown was not only a home, it was a school as well, a finishing school. And if you didn't pass your courses, you were finished. But if you survived, it looked like this. Oh.
high on a slope of a hill. Keeps growing.
Listen to Boatman.
Never I want you.
swing.
Thank you. What is it about the music we make that makes it the music of yesterday, today, and forever? Maybe that today is a result of the yesterday spent in wooden churches. Singing the praises of our maker in joyous harmony and love. And part of it has to be the songs we sang, working under the blazing sun to help pass the hard times. Yesterday was also Bessie Smith, and Satchmo, New Orleans, and gospel choirs, slavery, and folk songs, and Bojangles, Ethel Waters. What about those rent parties, huh? Remember those? Yesterday was hot. Yesterday was hurting. And yesterday was the birthplace of today. You know, today is 25 years of climbing and building and opening doors and breaking old rules. Today is also love songs. And guy and girl songs and songs of protest and anger. Songs of gentleness and songs of wounds left unattended for far too long. It's songs to dance to. It's songs to march to fly to make love to make love to. It's music pure and simple and hard and soulful, if you insist, full of promise and determination and unity and humanity. My loved ones, today is the birthplace of forever.
There's far too many of you died. You know you've got to find a way to bring some love in here today. Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. Oh, it's not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way, bring some understanding every day. Picket lines,
sister.
Picket signs,
sister.
Don't punish me,
sister,
with brutality,
sister.
But talk to me,
sister,
so you can see,
sister,
what's going on.
What's going on?
What's going
on? What's going on?
No show about Motown would be complete without a salute to the unsung heroes of the music business, the disc jockeys. Hour after hour, year after year, through rain and sleet, rock and roll, pop and soul, funk, and you know what. They're out there spinning the discs that you like to hear. They make the country move. To represent them tonight in all their splendor are two of the legendary platter spinners from WKRP in Cincinnati. Howard Hessman and Tim Reed. You probably know them as Johnny Fever and Venus Flytrap.
Thank you, fellow babies. It's a pleasure to be here. And yes, WKRP is defunct now, but we are about to get refunct. It's the early 1960s, and you are listening to pop music on your radio. And you have my condolences. There wasn't a lot happening. It wasn't very hot. Then things started heating up a little. But most of that rise in the temperature is coming from Detroit. And with her monster 1964 hit, this next artist flipped my fan switch to a permanent on position. Center stage for Miss Martha Reeves.
My children, this is the velvet voice of versatility, bringing you sounds that will surely cause your hips to dip. The platter I'm about to lay on you is from Miss Mary Wells. Oh yeah, tell them, darlings.
There's nothing you can say could tear me away from my guy. Stuck like glue, my God,
my God,
my God,
my God.
Stick to my God like a statue, a letter like birds of a feather. We stick together. I'm telling you from the start, I can't be torn apart from my God.
Oh, Mary Wells, take me now. You know, babies, it was the deeply righteous William Shakespeare who once said, "If music be the food of love, play on." Well, by the mid-60s, Motown had put soul food on the musical menu. Now, maybe the Rolling Stones can't get no satisfaction, but we can with the hard-driving sound of one of Motown's all-time greats. Here to blow you away with a double-barrel blast from the past, it's Junior Walker and his Shotgun!
My children, it's time once again to explore the musical galaxies of rhythm and blues. Looking down on your planet from my vantage point in the ionosphere, I detect some movement on the ocean of soul from a nautical group known as the Commodores. Yes. Sailing to the top of the charts with Freak Out. I'm talking thirsty words.
Here we go, come on.
Ow, she's a freak.
Everybody say what?
Ow. She's right. I guess it didn't at all hang out. Ow, she's a freak. Ow. I like the ladies that, that's a fact. Ain't holding nothing back. Ow, she's a freak. Come on. Ow. Well, she's the one, the only one. Built by the Amazon. Everybody sing along. Then it all hang out. Ow, she's a freak. Ow. Well, she's the one, the only one. Built by the Amazon. Come on now.
Let me find out something real quick. How
old are you?
Six.
6 years old? Well, I better find out one other thing. Are you married?
No.
No. You have a boyfriend?
No.
You like boys?
No.
You don't like boys. I want to sing a song to you. You want to hear a song?
No.
No. Wait a minute. Before we get started, I want them to see the smile that you have. Look at this. Where are you? And I think what I'll do right now is have you come real close to the edge, because this song is especially for you.
Oh, you, you mean more to me than any man I've ever known. I want to give you all my love, just you alone. Oh, you're all my dreams come true.
Motown 25 will return with Michael Jackson, Diana Ross, Linda Ronstadt, and Billy Dee Williams.
Thank you.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Sensational food. Here, the Jackson 5.
I didn't want you around. Those pretty faces always amazed you. I stand up in the crowd. Some I wanna pick you from the bunch. When the land was all of the chick. Now it's much too late for me. Take a second look. Oh, baby, give me one more chance.
So sure ain't that
enough. Won't you please let me
back in your heart?
Oh, darling, I was glad to let go.
Let you go, baby.
Now since I see you. Yes, I do now.
I want you back.
Ooh, ooh, baby.
I want you back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I want you back.
Nah, 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 nah.
I want you back.
Salvation back. Where there is love, I'll be there.
I'll be there.
I reach out my hand to you. I have faith in all you do. Just call my name and I'll be there.
I'll be there.
I'll be there to comfort you. Build my world and dreams around you. I'm so glad that I find you.
Oh!
I'll be there with the love that's strong. I'll be your strength.
If he doesn't, I'll be there.
I'll be there.
Come on, everybody sing. Don't you know?
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, those, I have to say, those were the good old days. I love those songs. Those were magic moments with all my brothers, including Jermaine. But, you know, those were good songs. I like those songs a lot, but especially I like the new songs.
That my love.
a sense of style uniquely its own. Ernie Burns captured it on canvas, and now we capture it on stage.
About Motown and the movies. When Motown went to Hollywood, it was not necessarily to make black movies, but to make movies with black stars. I've had the pleasure of working in a number of Motown films with some very wonderful actors like Diana Ross, Richard Pryor, Anthony Perkins, James Earl Jones. And when I say pleasure, I mean it. But a picture is worth a thousand words, especially in the film business. So I'll just let the pictures talk for themselves.
You're gonna be in the movies. That's right. You're gonna be famous. You're gonna be a star, right? What came up? Lady sings the
blues. She's got 'em bad. She feels so sad. Like me, I've been at bat 100 times, I got 25 hits. That's simple, right? 25 going 100 four times. Gives me a batting average of 4. That's wrong.
Listen to Bingo and Steel O'Boy.
Do you get what you're hoping for? When you look behind you, there's no windows.
I'm a success.
Let me tell you something, and don't you ever forget it. Success is nothing without someone you love to share it with.
Motown sound is the phrase that has been applied to all the music here tonight we've been listening to. But what exactly is the Motown sound? What? Here to explain what some of it is are some of the people who really should know.
What is the Motown sound, though? All right.
Well, I think the Motown sound can best be described as...
I think it's the snare drum, whatever you call it. I think the tangerines, you know.
Finger pops, a tambourine, heavy bass, thump, 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 the beat of a happy heart.
Well, the Motown sound is the bottom. You know, they got the foot working and you can hear the bass real good.
A lot of treble, high end to it.
It's the sound of... drums, it's the sound of the four tops, and
it was a rough sound.
The gospel sound, the gospel hallelujah sound, you know, tum, 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 oh, dang.
It was a combination of rats, roaches, love, guts.
The Motown sound is a combination of chitlins, grits, and the ghetto.
Now that's the Motown sound.
No, I disagree totally. The Motown sound is a complete feeling, a feeling of people who were there.
The Motown sound is Americana.
The Motown sound is a lot of love, a lot of feeling, a lot of togetherness.
It's music, it's life.
It's just the total picture.
The point is, I don't know what the Motown sound is exactly.
Now that's the Motown sound.
Now you all understand. One of the biggest kicks is being in on the beginning of a career. It's hard to realize that all the acts on this show, when they came to Motown, were just kids off the street. But it's true. And here are two of the hottest and most exciting groups on the horizon today. DeBarge and High Energy.
Solve them, but you found the answer. You told me to take this chance and learn the way of love, my baby, and all that it has to offer. In time, you will see that love won't let you down. All that I have, I give my all to you. All, all my He appears to be straight from heaven, but everybody says that the devil in those veins still lies. They tie me on the side. Woo! Opens his mouth and there's magic. A beautiful smile looks like the one to take.
For Rick James. Rick James and the Stone City Band. They're busting out.
But I'm only human.
you've made mistakes too. I'm the life of the party, cause I tell a joke or two. Although I might be laughing loud and hearty, way deep inside I'm blue. So take a good look at my face, see my smile looks out. Trace the tracks of my tears. Don't you know I need
you? Need you?
Need
you?
Since you left me, if you see me with another guy, looking like I'm having fun.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Although it might be cute, he's just a substitute. So take a good look at my face. Oh, you know my smile looks out of place. Yeah, if you get closer, it's easy to trace the tracks of my tears.
Those are both great songs. All right, you know, I loved them so much I recorded both of them myself. Stole every lick I could from your records, too. Have you ever written a song that wasn't just a smash hit?
Oh, yeah. Heck, yeah. In fact, I can recall one song that I wrote that didn't sell a copy.
Not even one?
Not even one. And I had some of the biggest people at Motown singing it every day.
What was it called?
Well, it's called the Motown Company Song, and it goes like this. Watch this.
Oh, we are a very swinging company, working hard from day to day.
Nowhere will you find more unity than at Hicksville, USA. Our main purpose is to please the world, which all the DJs are glad to play.
Our employees are all the best
here at Hicksville, USA.
Our employees must be neat and clean and really have something all about. Honesty
is our only policy.
We're all for one and one more.
Hicksville, you'll find more unity than at Hicksville.
Hey!
At Hicksville!
At the Hicksville, USA!
Once upon a time in a kingdom known as Detroit, lived a young warrior named Barry. And as a youth, he fought in an arena with padded gauntlets for small sums of money. Got his brains beat out. So Barry took employment at a local chariot factory called Ford. And there he learned skills of the assembly line. But his heart, alas, was not in his work. No. He took on the ways of the minstrel then, and he began to write songs for others to sing. And a local celebrity, Sir Jackie of Wilson, heard some of the songs and put them on circular platters called discs. And the townspeople liked the sounds that emanated from the press disc. And they said, and turned them into something called hits. But Barry realized something was astray, a bit awry here. Oh, yes. You see, the great wealth he had anticipated never materialized. He was busted. So Barry went out on a great quest, and he found miracles and wonders and marvelettes. And he brought the discoveries to a secret place called Hitsville, and there he taught them wondrous things. There was young Smokey of Robertson, and Mary of Wells, and Martha of the Vandellas, Marvin of Gay, and Tammy of Terrell. And there were pips and knights named Gladys. And temptations and tops and contours and spinners. And before anyone realized what was happening, it happened. Hitsville became like its name, a house from which have hastened for mine somehow. And Barry said to himself once more, "Self, this is a lot better than being punched in the head by padded gauntlets." And all was going well in Hitsville. My wife, with the ankles walking. But you understand. And our young hero met three fair maidens from the projects of Brewster. He groomed them, he gowned them, he nursed them, rehearsed them, then gave out the news that Motown gave birth to the Supremes. It was like something out of a fairy tale. And the family grew, and everything they touched turned to gold. And bulging pockets. And Barry, he had climbed the beanstalk and faced the great giant and captured the goose that laid the golden records. And after 25 years, there is a chance, and everyone wants it, that it will happen to them. And all will live happily ever after. We love you, Barry, very much.
Motown songs also live happily ever after, especially if they're performed by stars like the remarkable Adam Ant.
Say it, baby. If you don't leave me, oh, please don't leave me all by myself.
I've got this burning, burning yearning, feeling inside me, deep inside me, and it hurts so bad. Oh, baby, baby, where did our love go? Don't you want me? Don't you want me no more? Baby, where did our love go? And all of your promises of the love forevermore. I've got this burning, burning, yearning, feeling inside me, oh, deep inside me, it hurts so bad. Oh, you were my heart. You were a perfect lover. But now that you got me, you wanna leave me behind.
You can depend and never worry. I know you must follow the sun wherever it leads. But remember, if you should fall short of your desires, remember life holds for you one guarantee. You'll always have me. Ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough, keep me from you. Ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough, keep me from you. Well, if I started talking about my life with Motown, I think I'd take a real long time. But Motown is forever. And there's a strange thing, but Barry has always felt that he's never been really appreciated. It's a strange thing. I feel a little emotional, but it's not about the people who leave Motown that's important, but it's about the people who come back. And tonight, everybody came back.
City, New Jersey. We welcome you back for more boxing. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert. And earlier on NBC's Ringside.